donuts. I got donuts. I got
donut. What's a donut?
Donuts. It looks wrong, but it is oh so right. Oh yeah.
And we're live for another episode of Duff and Donuts. I am your host, Kia Not Keith. With me today, as always, is my lovely co-host and my beautiful partner in crime. Not real crime, yet. B. Today, we had a one-week hiatus. We're busy with parenting stuff, so, you know, that's our excuse if we don't have an episode. It's parenting stuff.
I mean, it's pretty legit. School did just start.
School did just start, so, you know. Our kid's a genius, so it's really hard to, like, you know, keep the schedule with, like, tennis and stuff going on. And harp class.
Blatant lies here, blatant lies.
Harp. Someone's gonna put that, like, and like if they ever have like a wiki page, like, their child plays harp.
Oh god. You couldn't come up with like a cooler
harp's
thing.
Cool, okay.
Like our kid does jiu-jitsu or something, you know? Like you're like, she has harp lessons, okay.
Your first thought is jiu-jitsu is a cool one?
I think it's cool. Is it not?
Yeah, do you want to do jiu-jitsu?
No, I mean, I just, you know.
Oh, you think it just sounds cool?
It sounds cooler than harp lessons. I mean, no offense if anyone out there plays harp, obviously. I mean, I'm sure it's
She's
nothing.
She's offending everyone. I'm sure harp it's not players easy. Are just like, dislike, unsubscribe.
Probably. They're like, okay, bye.
Like, famous harp players are listening to this. But no, we are doing Duff and Donuts. We are at a week hiatus. And actually, this week, we're not even doing a Simpsons episode. What? We are doing a breakdown of one of my favorite YouTubers, and, like, Brittany just found out about him because, like, he did two videos on The Simpsons. One was 2 years ago, and the other one was a week ago, and it's called Super Eyepatch Wolf, and his videos were called The Fall of The Simpsons and Modern...
Nope. Hold on. Oh, boy. Where was it? I don't even know.
Hold up. We're finding it. I'm finding it. I have Eyepatch Wolf tabbed on me. So, like, but Brittany has never, like, fun fact, before me and my wife started dating, I used Super Eyepatch Wolf video to, like, talk to her about the bizarre modern reality of The Simpsons is the second video we're going to talk about. So we're talking about two videos. There will be a link down below, but you should definitely listen to them. Because they're very fascinating to me as a person who's never watched The Simpsons. And I don't know about her reaction yet, but we're going to talk about it. But to get into context, I use Super Eyepatch Wolf while he's talking on his Let's Fight a Boss podcast, as well as like the first video, The Fall of The Simpsons, to like have conversation starters with my wife before we started dating. Because she's like, oh, I like The Simpsons. I'm like, yeah, you know, do you remember, like, how, like, season 9, the principal and the pauper, like, changed the modern landscape of The Simpsons? Like, I, like, knew what I was talking about.
Sneaky, sneaky.
She fell for it, and now we're married, and she can't take it back.
I mean, yeah, not until the life insurance kicks in, we can't do anything about it.
But no, like, so let's go to the first video, which is The Fall of The Simpsons. This is definitely gonna be my wife versus a video because, like, I could see some of her faces of some of the opinions. Like, I know when my wife's getting like I don't agree is when she smacks her lips like, and she's like typing real fast, like really hard and angry.
No, oh my gosh, no.
So what did you the video in general for you as a Simpsons fan? I want to hear your opinion because I'm gonna obviously have a different opinion on it.
Right.
But because I don't watch The Simpsons as religiously as you and he does, you probably have a better, like, you could make a better counterpoint if you disagree than I could ever do.
Well,
also, I'm also drinking a nice draft root beer of cherry cranberry. Spurschifferger. I don't speak German very well, so Spurschifferger.
What is that?
It's the cherry can. It's got a cute little...
No, I mean, what were you just doing?
German.
It sounds like you're trying to say, like, the Flintstormer from that Cloudy with a Chance of Meatballs.
It's Fire Brewed, so you can check it out at your local... We have a local, like, soda shop. I don't know if you're from a small town, then you probably don't. But check it out! But you, go on.
Actually, to be honest with you, I actually think that he made a few good points.
Mm-hmm.
I think some of it was more hard for me to swallow versus disagreeing.
Really?
Yeah, because his the way he broke it down and the way he talked about it made sense. You know, I can see it from other people's perspective. You know, he talked about how right now we're kind of in the zombie Simpsons stage of it, you know, which I kind of agree with, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we literally watched an episode where Bart was doing online gaming.
Yeah, yeah.
And then Homer destroys an entire grid system of Seoul, Korea, and it ruins their economy.
Yeah, I'm not denying.
No, 100%. I'm just saying, like, I understand, like, watching it with you and I watch it, like, not...
Versus watching the older episodes.
Yeah, like, you and I will watch, like, the... Because, like, I recently bought one of the Treehouses of Horrors that I really enjoy. And so, like, watching that, and then, like, I decided to watch the modern Treehouse of Horror, and no. I'm just like, I'm not for this.
Right. I mean, it all has to do with source material, et cetera, mm-hmm. too. But a good point that... I'm sorry, who was the
Super
guy?
Super Eyepatch Wolf. Okay. You can just call him Eyepatch Wolf.
One good point that he made was that when The Simpsons started and when Simpson Mania happened, they were kind of different characters, obviously, than they are today. That he talked about how the original people who worked on the show, like Sam Simon, James L. Brooks, you know, he talked about how they kept the characters true to the way that we would expect the characters to act. You know, Homer was driven by five things he mentioned. What was it? It was like...
Wanting to be left alone.
Laziness.
Alcoholism.
I don't think that was part of it.
No. I know one of it was
like,
family.
He loved his family. He loved his family. But he was stupid.
He was stupid.
So everything that Homer did... you know, joke-wise, plot-wise, even if the plot got a little skewed and a little out there, we could expect Homer to act like Homer.
The action that happens to Homer is a typical reaction of Homer.
Yeah, exactly. And I agree with that. It's, you know, definitely Homer during, you know, what we're going to call Simpsons Mania versus the zombie Simpsons today, he has changed quite a bit. You know, they pointed out that there would be 12 writers, and they would work for, like, 11 hours a day on a single episode, and it really showed. Mm. You know, they were talking about how they broke up a joke into, like, five smaller jokes.
Mm-hmm.
He gave the example of when Bart sells his soul, and he's riding to Milhouse, his grandmother's house, to get his soul back, mm-hmm. and his bike gets run over by a street cleaner, so that's one joke. Then we find out he thinks that the bike is just cleaned instead of actually, like, broken.
So he's like, that's a stroke of good luck, so that's another
joke. But then the bike falls apart when he goes to ride
it
again.
And the last joke is the guy laughing and then falling into the...
Yeah, the street sweeper meant to do it, and so he's just some kind of, like, evil dude, and then he falls into the subway system. So it was a very broken-down joke. And he compared it to a new joke. I forget which episode he said it was from, but it was definitely from, like, one of these way later seasons.
No, he compared it to, like, what he did was he compared it to a laugh track in, like, modern sitcoms.
Oh, no, not that. I was going to compare it to the other Simpson joke, the one-liner one that he
talked
about.
When
Homer's sitting in the airport.
Yeah. Oh, no, so that was a made-up one. That was the one where they're like, someone wrote it both of those in the modern Simpsons and the old Simpsons.
No, it was an original joke, but then they rewrote it.
Did they? And
yeah, that's what he was saying.
No, because he said in the blog post, the emphasis is that they made a joke about Homer, how zombie Simpsons Homer, the air attendant's like, all women, children, and fat people bored, and Homer's just sitting there. And then a steward has to come and be like, sir, and point to the line, and Homer goes,
Doe. Realizing, like, oh, I am fat. But the original joke was, I want to say it was on the episode, because I want to say I saw that one.
I don't think so. I think that this one was a written one. I think this was a good. This is a blog post. I've watched this one I watch all of Eyepatch Wolf's video a ton.
Right.
Like I listen to Eyepatch when I'm running, so like I listen to that religiously.
Okay. Well, so, originally Homer was sitting there and they said the women, children, and fat people can board, and he was just like, "That's me."
And walks
there. So that's not really funny. That's something you could put a laugh track to versus like a broken down joke where there's several parts of it.
Yeah.
Which is comparing the Simpsons Mania days to the modern day Simpsons.
Yeah.
Like now they're cheap one-liner jokes that every single series is doing
like
now.
It is super like when they showed the video of Big Bang Theory without a laugh track.
Yeah.
That was really unsettling to me.
Yeah, because like it tells you when to laugh. If
yeah.
the joke is funny, you don't need to be told. Is
right.
what he said. Yeah,
yeah.
And it's true. Because the old Simpsons. When they did jokes like that with Bart and, you know, his bike falling apart, and it's a continued joke. Not only does the character act like the character and stay true to who they are, but also the joke itself is really funny.
Mm-hmm.
And you can tell that someone sat there, and I believe they said something about, like, there's, like, 30 to 40 drafts and rewrites
mm-hmm.
of a single joke.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, that's dedication. They called it layered comedy is what he called it.
And I think that is 100% dedication. I think that is, like, why I always bring up, like, them being in the writing room all the time on our podcast since,
mm-hmm.
like, the first episode. Because it's just very true that it's very, like, there is episodes that I did not like. Like, remember, the Telltale Head, I don't like. I think that episode is just lame.
I mean, not every episode is going to be for every person.
Right, no, 100%. But you know what I mean, though? Like, but it was still, there was parts of it that I still found really funny.
Or really touching,
yeah.
you know, like Homer and Bart's relationship in that episode.
Mm-hmm.
Homer's personality, I believe he points out, too, Homer has changed from just being like a
dumb,
funny because he's dumb, but he means well to like, yeah, he called him jerk ass Homer.
Mm-hmm.
He also said like wacky psychopath nonsense to his actions.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where classic Homer was layered into
mm-hmm.
those five characteristics
yeah.
that he talked about. And it's so true. It really is. You know, Homer, as we've discussed in past episodes, you can see that he cares for his family.
Mm-hmm.
You can see that, you know, maybe he is lazy, but he, you know, it's not like the newer episodes where he's like, I think there's one time Bart's like, do you even have a job anymore? And Homer's like, I think it's pretty obvious that I don't. And it didn't like play into the plot or anything. It didn't like take it anywhere. It didn't explain how he got back to work or anything like that. It was just
mm-hmm.
kind of like thrown in there to be funny, I guess. But,
you don't think it's funny, right?
I don't
like,
think it's funny.
Okay.
No, I don't. But I honestly thought that it was interesting, his perspective on that. But some of the jokes that he didn't like, some of the nonsense plots that he talked about was, like, when Bart works at a burlesque house, he called them, like, boring stories, like, when Homer was a boxer and stuff like that. And
I mean, you didn't say boring. I think you said, like, just more
outlandish stories. Yeah, I was like, I love the burlesque house episode. That's actually one of those like classic ones that people quote a lot,
uh-huh.
you know, and the stonecutters episode and the Frank Grimes episode. That's
See, I like that Frank Grimes one.
Yeah, that's one of those classic episodes, and a lot of those were season 7 and 8 and 9.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't necessarily disagree that The Simpsons wasn't good after that point. I see his point that because a lot of the
it got
original
weird.
Writers weren't on there anymore,
mm-hmm.
I can see that it definitely went through, like, a transition, and I can see that it definitely changed a lot, but I wouldn't say that it got bad, at least not in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. No, that's understandable.
I know that I'm in the way majority when I say this.
Minority.
Oh, yeah, minority, sorry. When I say this, the Principal and the Pauper episode, when I was a kid and I saw that episode for the very first time, I didn't hate it. I really didn't. I laughed. I thought it was a funny episode.
Have you seen it recently, though?
Yes, actually, I have.
You have? Okay.
Yeah. other than the plot, like the ending being kind of rushed, like having them just be like, oh, we like this Seymour Skinner better, you should just get on a train and leave, you know, and they tie him to the chair and stuff. Other than that being kind of hurried and rushed and like the rush to get back to the normal or whatever, I enjoyed the ride of the episode. I think I was like, ooh, what's gonna happen next? And I was like curious to learn more.
It never goes anywhere besides one offshoot episode where Bart's like,
I know,
something Tanzair, and he's like, move along.
See, but that is an issue between Simpsons today and Simpsons back then, is although everything kind of like resets at the end of the episode, they used to kind of have some continuity to mm-hmm. them, if that's even a word. I don't even
continuity,
know.
Continuity, yeah.
Like Lisa being a vegetarian, that continued. Mm-hmm. You know, when Apu and Manjula got married, that obviously continued, and then they ended up having kids and stuff. But they have a really hard time staying consistent with certain things.
Krusty's kid.
Yeah, Krusty's kid. I mean, I guess it is heavily implied that he's a bad father. It's kind of like one of those deadbeats, but...
Right. It's just a weird thing, and like... I think, like, again...
Because they brought her back for the
League of Legends episode.
Yeah.
Where it's just that, like, my dad never sees me. I'm like, all right, I get it.
Right. Like, it was really weird to me. Like, I think I pointed it out to you that they were... That she was part of that
online and they
group.
Didn't... She was like, so, who's the other nerd that's with Martin? Who talks like this? And where's the glasses?
Oh, jeez. I wish I could think of his name right now. I'm a
bad
terrible
Simpsons fan.
I am.
Yeah, that kid should have been there.
Yeah, or... I don't know. Maybe someone better.
Yeah. I think they just needed it, like... No,
it just shouldn't have been so
I think they just needed a girl. Like, I would have been okay if Lisa wanted to play.
Mm, it was kind of because
that
seemed
that would
though.
Seem like a thing Lisa would do in the modern Simpsons that I picture.
Do you think?
She'd jump onto trends.
I guess.
Did
I
you not
know.
Remember that it time could've... Lisa walked around a college?
Yes.
And she's like, oh my gosh, people playing hacky sack. Oh my gosh, dreadlocks. That's
okay,
so
what
new.
About, like, Janie? Or Allison, they could have brought Allison back.
It was Allison.
Ugh, the redhead Lisa's rival thing because she's smarter than her.
That's Janie, isn't it?
No, Janie's got like the purple dress and the curly hair.
Okay, I don't.
No.
Simpsons, yeah, okay. I'm a fan.
Okay, let me go back to the principal and the pauper though.
Oh, you have a whole thing on this?
I do. I wasn't
oh my
done.
God.
We got sidetracked.
Yeah.
So, I personally, when I watched it for the first time as a child, I liked the episode. Mm-hmm. But, listening to this, I actually understand how people didn't. Because I used to kind of be like, why? I think they're being babies about it, kind of, to a certain degree. I'm just like, just
Wait,
enjoy the episode.
Is this the thing but that people are just like, don't like the principal and the pauper?
It's a whole internet thing. Everyone's like, that's when the Simpsons died. But there were several great episodes after that one, just gonna say.
Do you, like, look, did you used to, like, look at Simpsons blogs?
No, not really. I'm not a super fan to the point where, like, I'm gonna follow everything everyone does kind of thing. I just literally watch the show, and I either like it or I don't.
Oh, okay.
You know what I mean? Like, I know some trivia about it, just acquired over the years kind of thing, but I'm not, like, a super, you know, like, I don't know everything, obviously. But...
You know a lot more than I would suspect you to know.
You think?
Yeah, my gosh, you know way much.
Thank you.
Like, oh man, some days, like, you'll be like, do you get that quote? I'm like, no.
Oh yeah, I just
watch
randomly
all
quote it.
5,000 episodes of The Simpsons on repeat.
Mm-hmm. Right. But anyway, I understood the point of that it tore away Principal Skinner's identity, and that the reason he was supposed to be like he was due to his mother and blah, blah, blah. But I always thought, after watching that episode, that perhaps the reason he was so anal and stuff like that was because he felt guilt, and that he wanted to live the real Principal Skinner's life for him in, like, you know, the best way that he could, kind of like his second chance sort of thing.
Mm-hmm.
I kind of thought, like, maybe, of course, his mom would have the influence because, you know,
but
he lives with her now.
But the age difference is just very big.
I guess, yeah. I mean, it was obvious in the episode that they both knew that, you know, she knew he was lying,
right.
You know? I mean, because she's like, oh, he's like, I'm going to go up to my room. And she's like, it's the second door on the left or whatever. You know, like, she had to tell him where his room was. She knew, obviously, that it wasn't him. But I honestly just kind of thought that it was like a... I didn't feel like it totally destroyed his character. Mm-hmm. And I know a lot of people did. They're like, mm-hmm. ooh, now I don't trust him. Mm-hmm. Now he's a totally different person. Mm-hmm. You know, I never got that. Uh-huh. I think some of the newer, well, not newer, I guess I'm old, but quote unquote newer episodes of like Flanders have totally like changed him a lot, in my opinion. Or like they pointed out in the video, like Mo used to be like just super shady and had like all these like weird backroom deals going on in his bar. You know, like he had a killer whale, and he had like pandas and stuff back there one time. Like he's doing some shady stuff, whatever, you know. And then now it's just kind of like, oh, he's this old family friend who's just kind of a goofball sometimes. You know what I mean? Like they kind of killed his character. And like you were talking about with Lisa, they completely killed her character. And I think I mentioned it in one of the first two Duff and Donuts that we did about how she does just blindly follow trends now. And
they made her woke.
No, they really didn't, though. I feel like they have made her insufferable.
They made her, like, a person who just, like, jumps, like, who's way high up on her high horse.
Well, because the whole thing is she's supposed to be really intelligent and mm-hmm. educated, mm-hmm. but she blindly follows these trends before, like, even knowing what she's getting into kind of thing. Mm-hmm. And I feel like a lot of things that they start to touch on in, like, the Zombie Simpsons episodes are way too age inappropriate for, like, Bart and Lisa to be going through. Like, when Lisa becomes a gymnast and she, like, the girls think that she's, like, a small person, like, oh, what is it? They think she's, like, a little person because they are. And she's in gymnastics and they're actually, like, college students or something like that. And then they smoke and they try to, like, get Lisa to smoke. And it's, like...
That's ballet.
Was it ballet?
Yeah, it was ballet.
Okay, but...
Boom, Beach Johnson.
No, you're good. A lot of them run together. But, for me in my head, at least. But, like, an 8-year-old is usually not going to be pressured to smoke.
Right.
You know, but I could see, like, that from, like, Bart and Jimbo more so. Like, yeah. They could have used that plot with Bart and Jimbo or something, but not, like, mm-hmm. Lisa. Mm-hmm. Or, like, that episode where she struggles with, like, her weight. And I get that it's, like, to a certain degree supposed to be, like, satire and stuff, but, like, to what, you know, like, it's just so ridiculous that it doesn't really, like, shed light on an issue properly, in my mm-hmm. opinion. Like, it's just kind of stupid. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, she goes to a store and she sees this girl and these other two girls are talking about, like, oh, I hear she's down to her birth weight. Like, it's just stupid. It's not really funny. It's not mm-hmm. really shedding light on a big issue. Like, it's not an age-appropriate thing for Lisa to be struggling with. Mm-hmm. You know, like, the depression episode, that had depth to it, because obviously anyone can go through depression. Mm-hmm.
But that Lady Gaga episode really spoke to me.
They also talked about that, too, about all the senseless
celebrity guests. Instead of making characters for the celebrities, they're just there, like... Hey, see you later, Blink-180. I'm not gonna lie, though. I like that Tony Hawk episode. Have no idea why. The only thing I remember from it is something I quote to my wife, like, once in a blue moon. I'm like, you're gonna go up. You're going down. And then you go up again. And then you're going down again. That's how it works.
Right, which is kind of funny. I mean, I'm not saying that the new episodes don't have some good jokes in them.
Oh, no, 100%. I get you, dog.
And I agree. But I think one thing that he pointed out that really stuck with me, though, is that Simpsons used to be kind of like counter pop culture.
Yes.
And then they just turned into pop culture.
Yeah.
And I was like, that hit me really hard, too, because I was like, yeah, you're right, because they did used to just kind of be like, they did touch on real issues, and it was supposed to be, like, the opposite of a real modern family, mm-hmm. you know?
Not a real...
A real American family,
yeah,
or whatever.
Yeah, it's the opposite of the sitcom family. Yeah. In the 90s. Like, it was the anti-Full House.
Yeah, and then now, there's just so many of those, like, copycats, you know, or, I guess not copycats, like, what do you call them? Like, they were influenced by the Simpsons?
Spiritual successors. I don't know. Like, I still think Family Guy is just kind of a hack of the Simpsons. I think it was just edgier. It was like The Simpsons was edgy for the 90s, and then Family Guy came around to be edgy for the 2000s.
Well, and South Park, like yeah. It was like Simpsons was
the grandfather.
No, like Simpsons was edgy, then Family Guy was like inappropriate, yeah. And then, like, South Park was like, oh my god, what did you do? Like,
South Park came out before Family. Like, South Park was, I feel, was heavily influenced by the Simpsons. But then Family Guy, I feel like they literally, they did a video, and this was, like, a video made, like, 10 years ago, where they did a side-by-side on episodes of The Simpsons and episodes of The Family Guy and how close and similar they were. Mm-hmm. And then, like, obviously Family Guy even made the joke where Homer comes in and he's like, oh my gosh, I ruined TV. And Peter's like, ha, I beat you to this one.
Right, because there's nothing The Simpsons haven't done at this point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Essentially, yeah, there really is nothing.
I mean,
The Simpsons even has their own, like, adult video parody.
Which is very unnecessary.
Yeah, they all dyed themselves yellow. They, like, painted themselves yellow. Yeah, no, I'm not, like, don't Google it. Yeah, that's how you know The Simpsons is just embedded in culture.
Right. I don't even know, really. I don't think it does good in the modern world. I feel like when they're trying to modernize The Simpsons, because...
Do you think maybe it doesn't, like, do you think, like, it's not that it doesn't do good in the modern world? It's just...
Maybe the way they go about it.
Maybe it's the way they go about it. Mm-hmm. It's no longer looking at it through a scope. It's more just like, let's make references in Facebook and Twitter and Instagram.
Right. It's no longer, like, layered comedy, mm-hmm. like they said. It's like literally any quote-unquote funny show out there, mm-hmm. you know, where they're just kind of like, hey, I'm going to say a funny one-liner, I'm going to get in this weird situation, and we're all just going to, like, kind of have some cheap laughs, you know? Mm-hmm. But it's not really, like, some of them are out of character, some of them are just, like, they don't make sense, or the plot itself doesn't make sense.
Going on.
I'm trying to think. I don't even know.
What else do you have in your notes?
Was that
it? Really, what you got out of it? Not in a bad way, I'm just saying.
Well,
because this leads us to the second video we watched, and this is the video that, like, I'm the one that, like, will have the expertise on, because, like, I'm a terrible person who likes to watch me look at memes and stuff.
Right.
So, like, do you want to transition, or are we... Because, like, the only thing I can say about this video is that, A, it helped me get my wife, and B, it was extremely insightful to me, because, like, I remember watching Simpsons, like, not religiously, but, like, it would be on at 5 o'clock on Fox, mm-hmm. KPTH, Fox 44. When I was a kid, and I'd watch it with my dad. That was pretty much it.
Right.
So, like, I think, and again, I like Super Eyepatch Wolf, so, like, any video that man, like, posts, I religiously watch. Like, I don't give a crap about Silent Hill, but I'll be like, yeah, let's eat this up.
I mean, honestly, I think he did a really good job. Mm-hmm. I think it kind of helped me understand better, like, what exactly happened. You know what I mean? Like, because... Other than just me realizing it, like, through the years watching it on my own, that obviously it changed and the characters changed and, like, the plots and everything and the jokes.
Would it make you want, like, I know we are personally doing, like, he did a broad version of what we're doing. He did the broad version of The Simpsons. Does it make you want to watch other dissertation videos on The Simpsons?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Oh,
okay, that's interesting.
Yeah.
That's good.
I like hearing other people's perspective about it, but I don't like just the bandwagon, you know, like everyone's
Do you think he was a bandwagoner?
No, I don't think so. I think he did a really good job of, like, staying true to the facts. You know what I mean?
You did a good job, John, because my wife is like she'll bite my head off if I don't know Simpsons stuff. So
I mean, I think, like, when you were watching me and you saw my face, I think it was more so, like, just an oh crap, like, that's kind of hard to swallow truth.
Like,
you know what I mean? Like,
very true.
It is true, and he did a really good job of highlighting that, I thought. So it was interesting for me to have it broken down that way, because it really made sense when you think about it, you know, the change above the writers and stuff, and then, you know, all the other parodies of The Simpsons and just the day and age changing and stuff, you know? Like, back in the day, it was really inappropriate for Bart to call Homer by his first name. You know, like, nowadays, that's not, like, you know, people aren't going to watch that on TV and go, oh, you know, like, oh, what a terrible little boy he, you know, what terrible parents they must be because he's so disrespectful to his dad, you know, like, then we watch South Park and Cartman's like, F you, Mom, you know, like, big difference, you know what I mean? Like, it's hard to shock people nowadays. So... yeah.
Let's run into, so this is going to be a longer episode than usual, apparently, because my wife had a lot to say about a YouTube video.
Well, you kept cutting me off on the principal and the pauper one. I didn't even finish all that.
All right. So, let's run into the next one, which is the bizarre life of modern day Simpsons. I like this video a lot, and I know you don't understand half of the shit that was in this video. And I will explain to you what you don't understand. Now, tell me, what was, like, so, as you know, what I try to do with Duff and Donut episodes as well is to find a meme that is incorporated with the episode, which I've only had one, which is the Skinner pathetic meme, which is a lie, because I also found out the pathetic part actually comes from Neon Genesis Evangelion, where a girl says pathetic to Shinji. I don't watch that anime, so I don't know their names. Like, you're surprised, like, oh, there's not an anime you don't watch, Kien?
Yeah, I'm looking at you.
Yeah. I'm getting to it. There's just so much anime. No. So, he literally goes into, like, The Simpsons, like, yeah, the TV show may not be good, but, like, The Simpsons still exists on the internet as a weird memification of itself. And it is bizarre because I follow, like, some of the Simpsons page, like, I follow Scenic Simpsons. Like, I'm not gonna lie, I follow that. It's weird to, like, be like, oh, I know, this is cool looking.
Right.
Like, Scenic Simpsons, he talks about, was there one thing in this video that interested you, like, that really interested you? Because I feel like one of them was probably Marge Simpson, the anime. I don't know why. It just seems like a thing that you might be interested just in looking up.
Honestly, all of the video kind of interests me to a certain degree because I don't just go on the internet and look for a bunch of stuff. You know, yeah, I know. Just search around and look for stuff. Like,
you just liked all my stuff before we got married. And so, then we got married.
So I didn't realize... mm-hmm. To what degree people were doing with The Simpsons.
But you obviously knew, like, the little, like, memes that would show up.
Oh, yeah,
up.
Of
like,
course, memes.
The,
like,
hiding,
I mean,
Bush Homer meme is, like, for some reason, like,
that's a thing,
the most go-to one that people use for things. Like, it's like when you become a Patriots fan and Homer's, like, going to the bush and then starts wearing a Patriots jersey, like...
Right. No, I mean, I guess I didn't realize what a big part of pop culture it still was, because I just kind of thought that there was a lot of people like me out there who were just kind of like, I watched it growing up and it was a great show and I might watch it still, but, like, it's not as great as it used to be, you know? Like, I didn't realize, like, there was all this out there. Not just the memes, but, like, you know, you mentioned the Marge Simpson anime, the Scenic Simpsons, where it's just...
Simpson Sentai.
Yeah. Oh, God, no. That shouldn't exist. I'm sorry.
Sorry. I was like, I didn't Google it. I was really tempted to after we watched it. But right. I'm like, my wife's going to judge me if I Google this.
Because
she already finds suspicions when I make jokes about that certain subject.
I mean, you joke about it a lot. Oh, so they say there's a little bit of truth to every joke. he mentioned how there's all these like Instagram pages about like worst Simpsons faces, which I ended up following because I was like, that sounds fun. It's hilarious.
Okay,
that's,
did you end up following
it's
some
hilarious.
Of these pages?
I did, yeah. You know, I knew the steamed hams thing was a deal. Like, I knew people were making like different memes about it and like remaking certain scenes and stuff, but I didn't realize that, like, I didn't realize how far that went. I didn't know there was like music videos and like people using like Minecraft and other like games
like
to
some,
remake
yeah,
the...
like my favorite one, and this is because I played it, it's the steamed hams done through the Nier Automata perspective, because Nier Automata is like an introspective game about like humanity and its choices. Mm-hmm. So like them making the scene of Seymour feeling regret and anxiety,
yeah,
like it's just, it blew me away, because I'm just like Eyepatch Wolf was right, because I watched that, I knew that video existed, sorry, I knew steamed hams the meme existed far beyond you, what you knew,
right?
Because, like, originally, when I was thinking of, like, doing a thing, it was going to be steam hams turned into basket case.
Uh-huh.
So they would be, like, do, like, steamed ham. Like, they use, like, I'll show it to you when we're done. It's just, they use the words from, like, they take the sound bites from the steamed ham scene and put them behind and make them rhythmically equal to the rhythm of basket case. It's one of my, like, it'll probably be the ending song, and we might be flagged on YouTube, but everywhere else will be fine. But I want to play that as the ending, because it's so fun.
I mean, just tag them in it up.
Yeah.
You know? But yeah, no, I found that interesting. I was like, okay, so I'm not the only person who's still kind of, like, you know, thinking about how much they shaped my life, you know, they changed it. Mm-hmm. You know, I wouldn't be the same person I am now. Obviously, I wouldn't have a lot of things to quote and reference if I hadn't grown up watching it. But you would find
something else. Like, I feel like, as much as, like, you say, like, I feel like you would fill the void with something else.
I don't know. I don't know what else I would have been watching.
King of the Hill, maybe?
I mean, I love King of the Hill, but not to that degree.
Not to that degree.
You know what I mean? Like, there's...
You're not a conservative Texas man who sells propane.
I'm not. Futurama, maybe? I don't know. But, see,
I really like
the thing about The Simpsons, though, is that it, since it is still on the air... And like he mentions, you know, like, yes, it's the lowest ratings of all times with this 30th season, but there's still millions of people downloading, like, the Simpsons Tapped Out game. There's millions of memes. There's so many different remakes, obviously, of, like...
Did you play the Simpsons Tapped Out game?
I did not. I felt like... I don't want to be one of those people that's like, I don't want to just, like, do what everyone else is doing, but kinda, you know, like...
A lot of people playing the Tapped Out. Like, I did not, like, again, guys, I am on the internet 24/7, but, like, I'm on the internet subcultures of, like, Japanese RPGs and stuff like that.
It so, also, like, might have came out at a bad time and for me to be, like, sitting down and playing a game.
Yeah,
you know what I mean?
Kid.
Like, I was quite busy. You know, he mentions, like, there's a lot of bootleg merchandise out there still, you know, like, of remakes of The Simpsons.
Yeah, it's really bizarre. Have you ever Googled, like, bootleg t-shirts of cartoons?
Or like, on BuzzFeed, sometimes they're like, oh, look at these, like, weird knockoffs of stuff, and it's, like, it's weird. I don't even know, man. But I didn't, you know, I knew, obviously, that there was, like, a lot of Facebook and Instagrams of The Simpsons. I just didn't realize to, like, what degree.
Right.
I guess, which I found really interesting.
I'm still trying to figure out that Lisa meme that I always post.
Oh, where she looks like she's gonna cry?
No, I found out that one. The one where, like, the first one I ever posted was Drake is just Nickelback for rap music, and it...
Oh, is it where she has the chalkboard?
Yeah, it's like it's an overboard screen.
Oh, the overhead projector.
Yeah, the overhead projector screen.
Isn't that the one where it... Wasn't that the bullying episode?
I don't know. I will find... I think it is.
It was, like, Francine the bully.
I'll find that. I will look it up. But, like, I just, like... I like that meme a lot. Because you can just put anything on there.
I want to say that's the one it was.
Yeah, you just put anything on there and it makes sense.
Which was also a really stupid episode. That bullies are triggered by
sweat.
The sweat. Like, oh, my God. I just can't even... But, actually, another point that he made in this video... Which we kind of touched on with the last one, too, is how The Simpsons are frozen in time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, they don't age. But, like, for some reason, like, Apu's kids are now older than Maggie. You know what I mean? When you see them and stuff like that. And he kind of gets into that with, like, the Marge thing. Like, how it's depressing that she's never going to, like, reach her potential or be anything other than just, like, revolving around her family.
That's why I think, like, I started reading some of the Marge anime.
Mm-hmm.
It's really interesting. I think it's beautiful artwork. I find watercolor to be very beautiful anyways.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be super pretentious. It feels the soul.
I almost feel like, and I'm sure a lot of people disagree with me, but if they're going to keep continuing The Simpsons, perhaps they could age them so that way they could have a few more plot points with people. Or, like...
Do you ever watch the Bart Hood episode where Bart is aging throughout that episode because it's a parody of Boyhood?
Yes. Yes, I did.
I thoroughly actually kind of enjoyed parts of that episode.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know what? You know what really bugs me, and I know I shouldn't let it get to me, but I do. There have been several quote-unquote future episodes of The Simpsons, you know what I mean, where they're like adults, mm-hmm. but they always change it. They always change certain mm-hmm. things are not, you mm-hmm. know, they need to stick with right. the first time that Lisa envisioned the future.
Mm-hmm.
They need to stick with that, in mm-hmm. my opinion. Like, if they're going to run off of it, like, at least, you know what, never mind. I'm not even
going to bring up the one I want to bring up, and that I actually followed the Bart Kira as it was being created.
I had no idea that was a thing. I had zero idea.
That whole, like, and I have a copy of Akira. It follows that page for page. It is bananas.
I thought that was this, I thought that was amazingly, an amazing idea.
Uh-huh.
That it was different artists for, like, every page, mm-hmm. drawing them in The Simpsons, like, in their own style versus, mm-hmm. like, just remaking it all in one other person's style or mm-hmm. something. I was like, that's cool. Like, that's I want to read cool. it.
Like, I wish I
had. I don't even know what... Is it Kira? Akira?
Akira.
I don't even know what that is. I'm like, I want to look like, you know?
I mean, we could watch it. I have a dub.
Oh.
You don't want to. I know you don't. And I know, like,
I want to read it. I want to flip through the pages and just appreciate it.
You can go on
the
like, artwork. There's the entire Tumblr thread of Bart Kira that you can read the whole thing.
Oh, that's neat.
Yeah, so, like, it was insane. Like, that, like, when I first heard about it, I'm like, this is going to be ridiculous. And then, like, I read it, I'm like, wow, the artwork is cool.
Yeah, I mean, that... I guess I didn't realize until he said that part, I didn't realize how blown up The Simpsons still are to some
like,
people.
Again, like, synthwave is weird. Like, you could put anything in the background of synthwave. That's why I use synthwave music when I'm, like, live streaming, mm-hmm. building maps, because it's super chill, serene music.
Right.
So even watch The Simpsons synthwave, it's bizarrely, like, just relaxing.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. I guess it made me also feel better after that first one that we talked about, like, the downfall of The uh-huh. Simpsons. It made me feel better about it to a certain degree, because I'm like, okay, no, they're not what they used to be,
uh-huh.
but they still mean something.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, they still have a spot.
I realized that this is a video that I knew, like, you have to watch, because I knew, like, you're a huge Simpsons fan. I run a podcast about The Simpsons with my wife. I don't particularly am going to get, like, El Barto tattooed on me anytime soon. So, like, I knew she would enjoy this more than I would. Like, I watched already. I really liked it. But I'm like, you gotta watch this. This is up your wheelhouse.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So, like, all in all, like, that last video, what did you think about? How did that, like, so it made you feel better about
yeah,
The Simpsons?
Yeah, it made me feel a lot better, I think, about That's everything. Good. Like, just realizing how they still have a spot. You know mm-hmm. what I mean? Like, the new episodes aren't as great as they used to be. The characters have changed. Some of them have changed for the worst. But I like that they still have a spot with people.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I like that people still think about them and appreciate them, and that, you know, it's bigger than I thought it was.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's good. Now you'll be hearing as I end this episode with the rendition of Steamed Ham's Basket Case. But I would just also like to let you guys know that thank you for always listening, and I've had well for your listing. I'm your number one fan.
Oh, God.
Yes, I really like he does listen, that's cool. Like, I'll fangirl over it. Like, I don't give a shit. But no, keep listening around. We'll be doing episode 9 next week. Sorry, I'm on my notes. I didn't have to, like, put up a Wikipedia page to read stuff, so... Bye, guys.
I hope you're ready for mouth-watering burgers. I thought we were having steamed clams.
I said steamed hams.
That's what I call hamburgers.
You got hamburgers, steamed hams.
Yes, it's a regional dialect.
Black region.
Upstate New York.
Really? Well, I'm from Utica and I never heard. Anyone hears the phrase steamed hams?
Well, not a Utica, no. But it's an old expression. Oh, family recipe. Oh, oh, oh no.
Steamed hams. You call them steamed hams. They are obviously incredible.
You don't. One thing I should. You don't skip me for 1 sec.
That's good.
Good time was dead by all I'm cooked.
Yes, I should be.
God, Lord, what is happening in there? Aurora Borealis.
Aurora Borealis. Within your kitchen.
Yes.
That's it?
No.
Up
it's just the northern lights.
Well, Seymour, I must say, you are an odd fellow. Well, you've seen a good hymn.
Oh,